Hello, you're watching SM Live at GSX 2021. Mark Folmer, President and Chief Operating Officer at Robotic Assistance Devices, is here in the studio today to discuss digital transformation. But be sure to watch his on-demand presentation on the impacts of digital transformation on physical security. It's available on the GSX 2021 platform through the end of the year. Hello, Mark, and welcome to SM Live.
Hey, Teresa, I'm happy to be here.
So let's start with the basics.
Yes.
We hear a lot about digital transformation, but what does that phrase mean when it's applied to the security industry?
It's definitely much more than a buzzword, right? I mean, we talk about it. The security industry is a little bit slower to kind of get there, but if you think about it as a process, right? So you're going from sort of using digital technologies to create new or modify existing, you know, business operations or types of business. It can be across, you know, the business itself. It can be across culture. It can be across different customer experiences. Mm-hmm. It can be really just how a business goes to market, right? Mm-hmm. And a lot of what the security industry has, and you think about sort of that physical security space, has not seen a lot of changes, you know, really over time. So kind of a short sort of couple of line way to think about it is reimagining the business that you're doing today with some kind of a digital age or digital transformation kind of aspect to it. So how are you delivering it? How are you delivering service? A couple of big bucket areas, process transformation, business model transformation, you think about domain transformation, and of course also cultural and organizational transformation. Mm-hmm. And all of those parts, you know, you hear those different kind of sections and you think about security right away, because security touches every single, from awareness to, you know, how people come and go from a building. So why not take a look about how things are done and how they get done, or how they can be done better? Yeah.
Fantastic. So as I'm sure that you can tell from this beginning of this conversation, you are uniquely qualified to discuss this topic. So tell us a little bit about your experience in the industry.
Thanks, Teresa. So 25 years in the security space, right? So 15 on the security service side, so real traditional, old school, you know, security service providers. Mm-hmm. About 5 years on the corporate security side with a large telecommunications company. And then now the last 5 years really focused on technology and how technology can impact security services, because that's my background. I had a couple of sort of corporate aha moments, I guess, during the, and especially or more so when I was on the corporate security team, where people would ask me questions and be like, hey, we should know the answer to that. But because the way that we were, you know, delivering services and so on, we didn't yet know, or we didn't know fast enough. So it was like, hey, there should be better ways to be doing some of this, and what can we do? What can we do about it? As you know, change is not natural for security people, right? Security people, you know, embrace it. But when your role is to manage enterprise risk, your role is to manage risk, you look at change and you're kind of saying to yourself, hey, you know, what else is this going to bring to me?
Right. Well, there certainly has been a lot of change, which brings me to my next question. So the pandemic led to acceleration in a lot of ways, thinking about things like remote work, and suddenly that was like a switch that was flipped overnight. So what acceleration has the security industry experienced, and how can we think about that?
I think it's, in a lot of cases, it used to be an us versus them. Right. Mm-hmm. It used to be, hey, there's physical on-site security services being delivered by people, and then there's this other side of, hey, there's technology coming to take all these people's jobs, right? Mm-hmm. And taking what people are doing. So, but if you think about the workflow and how things get done, okay, building access, you know, building accessing into a premise, can that be done interacting with a person, or can it just be going through a device? And really looking at, you know, all those different interactions and saying, hey, what am I trying to get at? What's the ultimate result that I'm trying to get to, and what am I trying to do? Now, it goes beyond just being efficient, right? You think about the question that we always get is, well, what's the ROI? If I'm going to spend money on technology, you know, what's it going to cost me and how am I going to save? It can be about a whole bunch of different things. Can it be about making things safer? Can it be about situational awareness? So if you are using human resources in a process, well, now let's equip them with some digital tools, whether that's for reporting, whether that's for alerting, and seeing how we can kind of match that up with people. And to what I said before, can it be about process flow, getting it right every time, right? I mean, we're humans, we make mistakes, you know, some more than others, but it can be about, you know, sort of weeding out those processes that you're like, hey, I'm looking for an exception. I'm looking for an exception. Wait a minute, an exception has happened. Now what do I do? Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. That's it. Yeah. And then, of course, a whole series more, but yeah.
Great. So obviously, we're talking a lot about security, which makes sense.
Yep.
But there are other functions in the organization, and they're experiencing digital transformation as well.
Yes.
So how does security think about the experience of other departments, and why should they be interested in that?
I mean, they definitely should be interested from the point of what are the risks? What mm-hmm. are the threats that are coming in, right? Mm-hmm. They also have to look onto themselves and sort of say, hey, if I'm not asking these questions about my organization, my security organization, for example, someone else might ask me, right? Mm-hmm. So I should really know what the landscape is and where, you know, where people are going and where they're coming from. Mm-hmm. And you think about the different threats, of course, that it brings on. You think about the different points, but not getting sort of, you know, caught, you know, kind of flat-footed and sort of saying, hey, I wasn't ready to address that. If you take a look at your own organization and you say, hey, from as a security service provider, how can I optimize resource deployment rather than saying, hey, it's just going to be about either deploying people going down that sort of person resource aisle or the current technology that we're all used to, cameras, access control, and so on. Mm-hmm. Well, what about other sections? How can I really tap into having a device or having some kind of technology support, getting it right all the time? Yeah.
Right. So obviously, when we talk about digital transformation, we think about technology,
yes.
but there is the people component to that
yes.
as well.
Yeah.
So can you talk a little bit about engagement with your employees and others?
Yeah. So why not look to digital technology or digital solutions and ideas in terms of saying, hey, if I take away some of these boring, mundane, repetitive, over and over and over again tasks and items, mm-hmm. and now have a machine do those ones, mm-hmm. I can act only on the alerts or when there's, you know, kind of a mm-hmm. white glove sort of thing. I'm interacting with a person, I'm mm-hmm. helping them with a problem or an mm-hmm. issue that they're having. So mm-hmm. then that way, the role becomes interesting. So mm-hmm. then now, you know, if you think about sort of today in terms of labor shortages and staffing mm-hmm. shortages and issues, mm-hmm. it's not a matter of, hey, can we find people? Because it's tougher and tougher to find people. Mm-hmm. Sort of keep people there, and it's tougher to keep people there, mm-hmm. right? So when you have that opportunity to kind of say, hey, let's use that, you know, mm-hmm. use the tools that are available to us to make the rules more interesting, and then that way they're more engaged, mm-hmm. and then that way the process becomes more accurate and people are happier about what they're doing.
So I'm going to throw you a little curveball. So
oh,
I know that you did a presentation on the future role of the security officer.
Yes.
You were on a panel for that. So it sounds like from our discussion that digital transformation is definitely tying into that new role for the security officer.
Yeah.
Can you share a little more about that from your presentation?
Part of it is necessity. You know, it comes back to, hey, we don't have people, we don't have the roles, right? Mm-hmm. Sorry, the people for the roles. So what can we do to go and take advantage of making sure that the organizations are still protected, that the risks that we've identified are still being covered? And mm-hmm. and now I think as an industry, a little bit kicking and screaming kind of here and there, mm-hmm. people are much more open to sort of saying, hey, you know what? I don't need to do this one-on-one. I can mm-hmm. do this, you know, through mm-hmm. available technology. And that's whether that's, you know, optimizing for data, you know, mm-hmm. the data insights. So what mm-hmm. is the security officer really bringing in terms of value? Okay, well, they're bringing insight, they're bringing incident reports, maybe. Mm-hmm. Well, all of that is now sort of being brought together and collated. And you can kind of say, hey, you know what? I don't need somebody at the front between these times and these times. Mm-hmm. I need a much more involved and much mm-hmm. better trained, for example, person in that back area, because that's where, you know, things are happening. And I think the industry's taking notice.
Yeah. Right, so it's a little more of a data analysis.
Yes. Yeah,
role,
take advantage
which,
of it.
Which is,
right?
which is very different.
Yeah. You think about security officers or security businesses are often measured by size. You know, mm-hmm. how many hours a week am I doing, you know, mm-hmm. in my business? How many officers are on my site? Well, now it's like, well, why measure just the size? Why not measure what they're doing? Mm-hmm. And then being able to kind of allocate that properly. Yeah.
Absolutely. More data.
More data.
More data.
Yeah.
So we've talked a little bit about some trends, but let's keep going. What trends are coming down the pike, especially as we move hopefully out of this pandemic phase? And how can security professionals prepare for those trends and take advantage of them?
Good question.
Yeah.
And very natural segue too.
Oh,
I mean,
you're very
well. Well done. So I mentioned kicking and screaming. I'm not saying that it's kind of an industry-wide thing, but there are certain advantages that can be really be grasped when you open yourself up to sort of looking at your what your processes or what your workflow is. We touched on data. What's really the value of the insight that people are bringing? What's the value that security is bringing, as opposed to the, you know, hey, nothing to report, or what have you done for me lately? It's just like, hey, this is what we're doing, this is what we're delivering, and seeing how that extends all the way through an organization. So as opposed to, oh yeah, I've got to go through the security process and that security person's maybe not doing what they're supposed to be doing, now it's just like, hey, I like interacting with the security person because I understand the value of what they're, so that, I mean, I think that's part of it. So how it's measured is definitely something that's an important. Taking advantage of the data and the insights also now from the program and what it's delivering, but then also what or how the threats are mitigated, right? So we trust a process that is going to be repetitive and is going to work sort of over and over again. So it's much easier to do that with technology and insight. So in a lot of cases, we're not measuring that today, and, and in other cases, we would be much better off if we did. Yeah.
Fantastic. So we want to not pit human against machine.
No.
This is kind of what we've been talking about here.
Yeah.
So do you think this is a mindset issue as well, that we just, people need to get their mind around the new reality?
It's definitely not man versus machine, right? It's what are the two of them together really going to be able to deliver better, right? So that to me is sort of the ultimate goal, spot to where you want to be. And you think about technology from the point of view of personal safety too, right? A security officer who's working alone in a touchy situation, now having to maybe enforce, you know, legislation that there's other kind of conflicting messages on, and they're not quite sure what to do. Well, why not have the idea of distance, right? So now you can be remote, you can be in a completely separate, you know, the back of the room, kind of dealing with a situation rather than face to face, and now being very confrontational. So that's a way where, you know, you're acting more on specific alerts, specific issues, specific items, rather than saying, hey, I've got to deal with everything, and then suddenly spike, you know, to kind of do something. Do
so
something,
it's not about technology, it's
at
about
all.
Problem solving.
What's the problem, right? What are you trying to get at? And that's going to dictate really what kind of digital transformation, to use the buzzword, you know, or processes that we have to review to kind of get going there.
Well, fantastic. Thank you so much for the conversation, Mark. Have a great GSX.
Thank you.
And thanks for joining us.
Yeah, it's been great being here.